must become him in God. So I'm going to give God praise right now.
Hallelujah.
I encourage you, women of God, that has a passion to go after the mandate of God over your life. Be reminded that you will not be accepted by many. Know who you are. When you understand who you are and whose you are, in spite of a person accept you, an organization, a people, a country accept you or not, you know who you are in Christ. And you just be pleased concerning where you are in God. And know that they, because they didn't accept you many times, the word declared that they didn't accept Jesus in some areas. But what he did, he continued to keep pursuing and going, doing the work of the Father. Tell you then, you got to work.
You got to work.
Proverbs 31 and 10 says, I encourage you, woman of God, and wives, especially in the Christian home, know that you have a noble character. The Bible said, who can find? She is worth far more than rubies. She doesn't lie. She doesn't commit adultery. She doesn't slander. She doesn't belittle. She doesn't steal. But she always does good for her husband. She's an awesome helper. These days we all read more the opposite. Sometimes it's the opposite. Like what I just said just now. Some women come in when they just into themselves, they love their husband. They are adulterous. They have low self-esteem. They have not been transformed from the word of God. They're nagging. And you know a nagging woman, men can agree on that. A nagging woman ain't got nothing to do with it. A woman who nags. And men, you see, what's man? Listen, one thing with women, we know what we're good for. The man, a woman wants something, she's going to continue to ask for it. And to a man, because they don't want to do it or they don't have the time to do it, it becomes continuously a nag. You need to know, too, as women, when you know it, you need to shut up. Shut up, man. Sometimes you nag too much. You just leave alone. If they ain't doing it, just rest on it. You can ask one, twice, and three times. That's what I'm going to do. Three times. After the third time, I shut up. Because I ain't coming back again. I believe in God. Because trust me, by the third time, anyone with sense will understand and listen and hear that it was something, was a great need, or I was asking you for something. So women, I encourage you, be that kingdom-minded